Minneapolis police are promising to focus on an area where a lot of students live and where violent crime is up.
That's right, the Marcy Holmes neighborhood. It is close to downtown and the University of Minnesota. That's where Kaya is live with how police plan to improve safety. Kaya?
Good morning. So this is First Congregational Church. This is where police met with neighbors just last night. Here's why. Because just last month, police responded to a report of a sexual assault in the area. Just last week, a U of M student reported an attempted abduction in the parking lot where she lives. Well, last year, there was a shooting in that same parking lot.
That's very serious, and that's very scary and traumatic. So that's one of the reasons, one of the main reasons that we're here this evening, is to talk about that and to answer your questions, your concerns, and anything else that you have.
Here's what police say they're doing about this crime. They're working with the landlord of that particular property, but neighborhood-wide, they've boosted patrols, and then precinct-wide, they plan to hold safety walks every week. Meanwhile, you have neighbors vowing to get to know each other, to watch out for each other, and to report crime. Some of them are also putting in their own home security systems. These are all things that you could do or consider in the neighborhood, wherever it is that you live. Chris?
Yeah, law enforcement trying to take a proactive approach in that neighborhood. Thanks a lot, Kaya.
Marcy Holmes is in the second precinct, which has the lowest violent crime rate in the city, but we took a closer look at the neighborhood, and according to Minneapolis police crime stats, violent crime has increased in Marcy Holmes each of the last 3 years, and so far in 2019, there have been 71 violent crimes. That is up from 59 at this time last year.
Here's a look at today's other top stories in your morning rush. 18 people now face charges in connection to those violent robberies caught on camera in downtown Minneapolis. The suspects are between 15 and 27 years old. The first brutal beating happened on August 3rd near Target Field. The second, a few weeks later, near 5th Street and Hennepin. The Hennepin County Attorney says in both cases, the suspects viciously beat the victims and tried to steal their cell phones. The second victim also lost his wallet, keys, and $100 cash. Arson charges have been dropped against a man accused of setting the Duluth Synagogue fire. The family of Matthew Amiot says he is homeless and he started a small fire to stay warm, but it got out of hand. Now the 36-year-old is facing a lesser charge of starting a negligent fire. Amiot could face up to 3 years in prison. A warning for people in Golden Valley. Police are investigating a report of a car that appeared to follow a junior high student after she got off the school bus. The girl said it happened last Friday afternoon near Lyons Park at Western and Louisiana. The car was a blue mid-sized sedan. And after being shut down for 6 months, Fort Snelling State Park is finally reopening. It has been shut down since March because of flood damage. Fort Snelling is normally one of the state's busiest state parks, but crews needed time to fix roads, buildings, and the main water supply line at the park. And that's your Tuesday Morning Rush.
The topic of today's Digital Dive had a lot of you talking on social media. If you're going to a Wild game this year, you're going to need a smartphone to get into the game. Yeah, all games at the X, they're going to be using a digital ticketing system. So you're going to need to show a QR code on the NHL app, Apple Wallet, or Google Pay to get into games. Screenshots won't be accepted either. Season ticket holders can still use their Forever Wild cards to get into the games, but everyone else, prepare to go digital. People had a lot to say about this on our Carolyn Facebook page, and not everyone agrees digital tickets are such a great idea. Here's some of your comments. Joanne said, my fear with digital ticketing is my phone conks out, gets lost, or I can't access the tickets. Paper backup should be accepted. And Matthew, though, disagreeing, he said it's going to be awesome. No more worrying about leaving paper copies at home since everyone carries a smartphone nowadays. And then Kai brought up a good point. She said, I think it's an elitist attitude that doesn't take into account that not every person on the face of the earth has a smartphone. I agree with you, Kai. So yeah, let us know what you think about this using the hashtag Sunrisers. They should have a backup plan, you guys, because say your phone dies, which mine does within seconds of turning it on, I feel like. What are you going to do?
Not see the game.
So yeah, I guess so.
Unfortunately. Yeah, they got to work on this, I think. And like the person said, not everyone has one either. But right. I mean, for me, it's great. I mean, I've been doing that for years.
Yeah. But I think a lot of people already think about these giant arenas as like kind of shutting out people who can't afford it. And that it's just another challenge, right?
Mm-hmm.
All right. Well, let's go to Laura with our One Thing Weather today, Laura.
Well, if you're looking at your phone, maybe you have a radar app, you'll notice that even though it's dry in the Twin Cities, there's a lot of shower and thunderstorm action happening just to the west and northwest. This takes a path off to the northeast today, so just skimming by maybe the west-northwest metro with a couple sprinkles. Other than that, it's hot, it's humid, and windy. But by this time tomorrow, we're dealing with another thunderstorm, a chance that might wake you up a little early Wednesday morning. Alicia.
And here's our morning slowdown. 35 south up near Forest Lake into the Columbus Split. Drive times are increasing. Unfortunately, we're working on a 19-minute commute from Viking Boulevard on 35 southbound to the 35 split in Columbus. So if this is your route, you may want to leave early. A detour option, you can hop on a Highway 61 to avoid sitting in that traffic jam. But other than that, you might want to leave early.
Thanks, Alicia. In our weather minds this morning, we're talking about trees here in Minnesota and how they're fighting back against climate change. Laura's here to explain.
Well, thanks, Gia. And when we talk about climate change, we often talk about how temperatures are warming, but also we're looking at heavy rain events increasing. And this year, we have seen a ton of rain. Of course, no one year determines climate change. But to date, we have more than 34 inches of rain. That's just below the wettest year to date, which was all the way back in 1892. Now, the DNR Forestry says that climate change is, quote, the most significant threat to Minnesota's forests over the next century. And of course, this heading right into leaf season. This from Moose Mountain, just sent in yesterday from Kathy, with leaf peak coming within the next month. Now, some trees are more suitable to adapt to climate change than others. Least suitable here in Minnesota, aspen, paper birch, tamarack, and black spruce. Meanwhile, if you're looking to plant some trees, these varieties are more able to handle what we anticipate to happen: the rising temperatures, the rise in strong and heavy rain events. Basswood, black cherry, northern red, and bur oak, sugar and red maple, would love those, and the eastern white pine as well. So all of that, when you're kind of planting trees, mm-hmm. Or maybe changing up your landscape, those are some things now, climate change, something to keep in mind. Will this be able to withstand this weather that we can expect?
Yeah. At least we have some options.
Right. It's pretty interesting. I mean, I guess you also go to like places like the desert in Arizona or something, and they have different kinds of trees there versus, mm-hmm. you know, but now it's kind of
even down
all over,
to Missouri. Yeah. You know, from here to there, you have different species and varieties that thrive there, mm-hmm. versus here, and yeah. all that will start to play out.
All right. Thanks, Laura. Mm-hmm. Well, Al Roker continues his reporting on climate change this morning. So coming up on the Today Show, he's focusing on the risks facing the home front, specifically at rising sea levels on the East Coast. According to experts, the sea levels are rising faster than anticipated, and some of America's most iconic locations, like the Statue of Liberty, are at risk. And that is coming up again at 7, right here after Care 11.
They've created a deadly addiction across the country, and in many cases, sit in your medicine cabinet, forgotten and unused. Coming up, what you should do with old painkillers so they don't end up in the wrong hands.
Then he helped the president get elected, and now he's headed to the hot seat on Capitol Hill. In 5 minutes, why Democrats think this guy is the key to impeaching President Trump.
And a change is coming to school buses in the Cottage Grove area, a change you don't really see in Minnesota. I'll show you what it is coming up in 20 minutes.